The Sepulchral Guard are the ancient inhabitants of Shadespire, who were trapped there by Nagash and are now trying to earn his forgiveness to escape the city. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint these miniatures using the Sepulchral Warden, and by following along all the techniques and methods we're going to show you, you'll be able to paint the entire warband. So without further ado, let's get started. The first stage of painting your miniatures is to undercoat them, and for these models I recommend you spray them using Zandri dust. Not only will this undercoat them, but it will also paint them the first colour that we need the miniatures to be. Now you can paint them Zandri dust by hand if you want to, and if you choose to do this then I recommend you spray them with Chaos Black undercoat first of all. But you can see for my miniature I chose to spray it with Zandri dust, and with that done we can now start blocking in some base colours. The first of these is going to be Lead Belcher for all the silver details, and always be sure to give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, especially with your metallics. Now I'm going to be applying this using a medium layer brush, which is the ideal size brush for the kind of details that we're going to paint here. And what you need to do is just get some of your paint and put it onto a palette, and you're going to see throughout this video I'm going to be using my palette all the time. It's really important that you do the same because it allows you to control your paint. It means that you can add a little bit of water to it to thin it down so it's smoother, and do this means the paint will go a little bit further, dry smoother, and also it gives you more control over it as well, which is really important. Now be sure not to overload your brush with the paint, you just want a good tip on the bristles there, and when you're ready start applying this to all the details that you want to be silver. There's quite a few here, you're looking at all the armour, so things like the breastplate like I'm doing just here, but there's also the chainmail that we've got down here, and there's various bits of armour on the limbs too, and also you want to be sure to paint the spear blade too, so apply a good coat of this all over, being as neat as you can. With that silver now base coated, we're ready to carry on blocking in all the other base colours for the miniature. And the next one of these is going to be Balthazar Gold for all the parts that are going to be bronze. So we're looking at a lot of details on the shield here, for example. But then we're going to move on to Corn Red for the cloak, followed by Abaddon Black for the fabric on his body. Then we're going to need Dryad Bark, and this will be for all the leather. And finally, we need Rhinox Hide, and this is for the fur around his shoulders. But we're going to be starting out with Balthazar Gold, which I'm again applying using my medium layer brush, and we're doing the much same technique as what we did previously. So again, use your palette to get your paint ready, thinned down so it's flowing nice and smoothly and so that you have lots of control over it. And when you're ready, you just need to pick out all the details that are going to be this colour. Now, like I said, we're mainly going to be painting this onto the shield, but there's also these little round parts of the armour just here, so be sure to get these parts. And there's one other very small detail that's easy to miss with this colour, and that's actually the ring that's on his finger just here. The next colour to apply is Corn Red, and this is for the cloak. Now when you're applying this colour, you might find that some of that Zandri dust undercoat still shows through once you've applied this colour. If it does, don't worry about it, just let the paint dry and apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Applying multiple thin coats like this is always the best thing to do because it ensures that the detail all stays nice and sharp whilst also giving you a strong finish of colour. The next colour to apply is Abaddon Black. Now this is for the fabric that we've got down here, and like before, apply two thin coats. Now at this stage, also be sure to paint the inside of the shield just here, being really neat as you get to all the bronze. Next we need Dryad Bark, and this is for all the leather straps. So you're looking at things like his belt down here, but also at this stage be sure to paint the inside of the shield as well. And finally, base coat all of the fur using Rhinox Hide. Now that we've finished applying all those base colours, we need to shade them, and all these colours can actually use the same colour shade, which is Agrax Earthshade. Now to apply this, you need a fairly large brush. I've got a medium shade brush here, perfect for the kind of thing we're doing, and what you do is just load it up with some paint and put it onto your palette as normal. You don't need to water this down at all, but it's a good idea to use the palette to control exactly how much you're applying at once. Now initially we want to put on quite a bit, so load up your brush and just start painting it on, and you'll see this paint runs into all the recessed detail and really gives it depth and definition. You want to apply it all over, keeping an eye on it as it dries, because it will tend to pull towards the bottom of the miniature. And if you see this happening, just move away the excess paint with your brush. But aside from that, just give it plenty of time to dry. And on a model this size, it'll take around about 40 minutes to dry completely. The shade is now completely dry, and you can see it's brought all those colours together and given the model loads of depth as well. But it has darkened it down quite a bit, so what we need to do is brighten up some of these colours and of course highlight them all too. Now the most important one of these is going to be the bone, so let's start with that. And we'll need a Shabti bone first of all for this. I'm going to be applying this layer paint using a small layer brush because I want lots of control as to where exactly I'm applying the paint this time. So you must use your palette to help out in doing this. So definitely thin your paint with some water so it's flowing really smoothly, like this, and then make sure you just twist the brush to get rid of the excess paint and to bring the bristles to a nice tip as well. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to apply this to the model on the bone, but avoiding recessed detail where more of the shade settled. So for the face, for example, what I'd be looking to do is to paint these slightly lighter parts going around the eyes like this, and around the bridge of the nose, along there, just avoiding that little chip that we've got in the bone there. And then you can see there's a bit of shade settled just above the eyes, just above the brow there. So I'm going to miss that and then start applying this colour just above it there like that. And this way you brighten the colour up, but you keep all that definition that the shade gave us. And you pretty much just carry on doing this across all the bones. So just take your time applying this colour. Now that we've finished applying that layer, the bone's looking really good and we're ready to start highlighting it. And for this, the colour we need is Screaming Skull. Now I'm still going to apply this using a small layer brush, and what we want to do now is again use the palette, but we've got to make sure that we've got even more control over it this time, because we're only going to be applying small amounts. So use your palette to thin the paint down and make sure you've got a good tip on your brush, and when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to pick out all the most sharp features on the bones. So if I go to the face again for an example, you can see we've got these sharper lines now around the face. So what I'm going to do is just use lines of this colour to pick those details out like that, just to give a fine highlight just to finish off the face there like that. And you basically just carry on doing this all across the rest of the bone, picking out things like the fingers and also sharper bits around here. Now one part that's different is highlighting the very top of the cranium. For this, what you want to do is, well, glaze it, it's called doing this. What you do is really thin your paint down quite a lot. See how watery it is there. Make sure you haven't got too much of it loaded on your brush, and then what you do is just apply this to the smoother area on top of the skull like this. And this way, as it dries, you'll get a really smooth highlight. With that highlight applied, the bone is now complete and we can move on to the next colour. Now the next colour is going to be going back to corn red to reapply it to the cloak, but this time it's for a different reason. We want to brighten it up rather than base coat at this time, so we're going to be applying it slightly differently. I'm using the medium layer brush to apply this, and what we're looking to do is apply it a lot like what we did with Ushabti bone earlier on. You need to make sure you've got it thinned down so it's nice and smooth, but as you apply it, you're looking to avoid the recess detail where the shade settled. So generally you're looking at the creases for this kind of thing. So you can see the creases we've got just there underneath the arm. What I'm going to do is avoid those recess details like this, painting on the flatter areas, just to make the cloak a little bit lighter, but also to keep that depth that the shade gave us. Now we've finished layering that cloak, we're ready to highlight all these colours. And the first one we're going to highlight is going to be all the silver details. For this, the paint we need is Stormhost Silver, and we're going to be applying it with a small layer brush because the technique we're going to use here is called edge highlighting. And it is literally that. You find all the edges and just highlight those parts. To do it, you've got to make sure your paint's flowing really easily. So, as always, use some water to thin it down. And make sure your brush isn't overloaded as well. What you want is a really fine tip in the bristles there. And so we are looking for all the edges on the silver details. Now a great example is on the breastplate just here. We've got this edge running around there. All I'm going to do is as neatly as possible just follow it along with this brighter silver like this, just to pick that detail out there like that. And the same is true on this kind of corroded part we've got here. Just follow around the edges like that. So you can see it's quite straightforward here, just following around all the silver details in this way. Now the only exception is the chainmail. For this, what you do is just make sure you don't have much paint in your brush and just lightly run it down like this, just to catch the links, very gently. You can see that gives you a highlight really quickly and easily. With those highlights applied to the silver, you can see all those details are standing out nicely, and what we need to do now is go along with the other colours highlighting all them too. They all use the same technique, so we're going to run through them quickly for you now, starting out with Cycorax Bronze to highlight all the bronze details. Then we'll need Wazdaka Red to highlight the red cloak, and because it's such a big feature of the miniature, we're going to take that a little bit further with a second, finer highlight of Squig Orange. After that, we'll need Eshing Grey for all the black details, and finally we'll need Gorthor Brown to highlight all the leather. But we need to start out with Cycorax Bronze, which I'm still applying with that small layer brush because it is the same kind of technique that we're going to do here. Again, use the palette to thin your paint down so it's flowing really smoothly, and then make sure that your brush isn't overloaded so that you don't lose control of the paint. And when you're ready, you're looking to pick out all the sharpest edges on the bronze parts, such as the rim of the shield just here. The next colour to apply is Wazdaka Red, and this is to highlight the red fabric of the cloak. And what you want to do is to pick out all the sharpest creases and also the edge of it too, as neatly as possible. So for the creases, we've got some under just under the arm just here. So what I'm looking to do is to go along the peak of them, so just along there like that. And then apply a fine highlight of Squig Orange to the cloak, just in the very sharpest corner. So you're looking at little areas such as just on top just there. And also little rips and tears, so just here for example, and also just on here. Eshing Grey is the next colour to apply, and this is to highlight all the black fabric and also the pitted little marks on the front of the shield. And finally, use Gorthor Brown to highlight all the edges of all the brown leather straps. With all those highlights applied, the model's looking great, but we do still need to highlight all that fur around his neck. And to do this, we're going to use a technique called dry brushing. The colours we need are, first of all, Gorthor Brown, followed by Screaming Skull. And to dry brush it, what you need to do is get hold of a small dry brush. Now, we're going to be starting out with Gorthor Brown for doing this, and what you do is use your small dry brush just to get a small amount of the paint on the tip of the bristles like this, then get some tissue and use that to work the paint in amongst the bristles and get rid of the excess paint too. You only want a small amount of paint left on the brush before you start to apply it. And what you do is just lightly start drawing it back and forth on the texture, and you'll see the paint catches the raised details and highlights them really quickly. Now, you do need to be careful as you apply it because we're very close to details that we've completed. So just take your time and be as neat as you can. Next, apply a dry brush of Screaming Skull, only this time be just a little bit lighter than you were previously. And with that fur dry brushed, we've now highlighted all our colours and we're ready to move on to basing. But at this point, if you want to, you can add a small amount of weathering to your miniature in the form of Nylac Oxide for some verdigris. Now, to apply this, what you need is a small layer brush, and this is a lot like a shade in how it behaves. You only need a small amount on your brush and use your palette to control how much you're applying, but what we're looking to do is to carefully paint this into all recessed details on the metal. So you don't need much on your brush before you start to apply it. And what you're looking for is little details like, such as around these little rivets we've got here on these plates. So what you do is just paint a small amount in there like that. And as you can see, it just gives a slightly aged feel to the metal and also a nice little bit of colour as well. And there we are, we've now finished painting the Warden and just need to do his base. And to do this, we're going to start out by base coating all the texture using Rhinox Hide. With that done, we'll then heavily dry brush it with Mechanica's Standard Grey, followed by a lighter dry brush of Dawnstone, and finally a very light dry brush of Screaming Skull. We need to start out with our base coat of Rhinox Hide, which I'm going to be applying with a medium base brush. And for this step, all you've got to worry about is getting all that texture painted with this colour. Still thin your paint down so you've got more control over it, but when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying it, working it into the texture as you go. And just be really close, very careful when you get to his feet, where you just need to be as neat as you can as you work around it, including the skeletal hand that's reaching out the ground as well. Next, dry brush all that texture using Mechanica's Standard Grey and the Rock as well, and you want to build up quite a strong colour here, so apply it quite heavily. Next, apply a dry brush of Dawnstone, but this time a little bit lighter than you did previously, and always remember, be careful of the feet as you do this. And finally, lightly dry brush the texture on the base using Screaming Skull. And once done this, all you need to do is paint the rim. Now for this model, I'm going to go for a Baden Black, but with that done, the Warden is complete. And with the base painted, the Sepulchral Warden is complete, ready to lead his warband in battle in the streets of Shadespire. So when you're painting this miniature, once you've applied all the base colours, you need to do an all-over shade on it with Agrax Earthshade. When you do this, keep an eye on this paint as it dries to make sure it doesn't run towards the bottom of the miniature and start pooling there. If you see that happening, just move away the excess paint with your brush. And then when you're applying your layers and highlights, remember neatness is the key, particularly on the bone. The better you make that look, the better the final result on the miniature is going to be. So we really hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and remember you can paint the entire Sepulchral Guard using the methods and techniques we've shown you in this video. But also, have fun leading them in battle against the other warbands too, and we'll see you all again very soon.